Hey, what's going on everyone? This is iReviews back with another video, and today I will show you guys 17 amazing iPhone tricks that you probably didn't know existed. These are new tricks that can be found hidden within iOS 14. Most of them, of course, are very useful and will make your life easier using your iPhone on a daily basis. Starting things off with Siri. With the latest iOS 14.3 release, Apple has added some new tricks to Siri, but they didn't talk about them or mention them anywhere. With iOS 14.3, now you can ask Siri about the sounds of different animals, cars, or instruments. So let's say we want to know how a piano sounds like or any like other instrument. All you have to do is just launch Siri. How does a piano sound like? And you will get right there the audio sample for piano in this case. Really, really cool. Again, you can do this for different animals, like maybe ask how does a lion sound like, or different cars. You can just ask Siri and you will get right there the information alongside with an audio sample of that sound. I've said this a few times on my videos and I'm saying it again. The app library is by far one of my favorite features of iOS 14 and I believe is the most underrated feature of iOS 14. So of course you go to app library, you will have all of your apps here separated into different categories, the search bar right there, which is very, very useful and makes your life way easier. But did you know that you can not only just search for apps there, you can also search for shortcuts that you might have on the home screen of your device. So here I have Auto Wall, which is a shortcut that I have created to automatically change the wallpaper of my device. And I can go ahead and if I have this on a folder somewhere on the home screen or any of the home screen pages, I don't have to search for it. I can just go to App Library and search for Auto Wall and I will find it right here. Not just find it, I can just tap right there on the icon and I can run the shortcut directly from App Library, which is really, really cool. And as you can see right here, it has changed the wallpaper. Now you can notice here I have as well a bookmark. You can also find bookmarks on App Library. So you go to App Library and you can go ahead and find any bookmarks that you have on the home screen of your device. And of course, tap them right here to open them directly from App Library to Safari. As I said, App Library has some really cool features and most of them are hidden and probably a lot of people don't know about. One of them is a feature on the search bar. So you know, when you're on the spotlight search, you're searching for something, let's say an app, it shows you the result. If you tap the go button on the keyboard, it will open the first result. Well, it is highlighted on the spotlight search. The first result is highlighted so you know what you're basically opening, but on App Library, you can do the same. It won't show you like a highlight here, but if I search in this case for Reddit, you can see it's the first result. If I just tap the go button, it will directly open that app without me having to go ahead and reach for the app. Really, really cool. And of course, it's very convenient. You're searching here, tap the go button. The first results that pops up will be opened by App Library. Another cool thing is that if you swipe here like this, it will go directly to the home screen. So whenever you're on the search bar, you swipe from the right to the left to go back to App Library, or you swipe from the left to the right and it will take you right into the home screen of your device. So that's really cool to know. So really quickly, you can get back on the home screen or just go ahead and get back to your apps. And the last feature of the App Library for this video. So let me just go ahead and show you guys this. If you want to delete an app from the home screen of your device with the new iOS 14 features, it is basically a process to do that. So you go ahead, tap right here to go to the edit mode. You tap the minus button. It shows you the like options here, remove from home screen and delete app. If you tap right there, then you can go ahead and delete the app. But if you do this from the App Library, it will be way easier. So all you have to do is just go to the search bar and just search for any app that you want to delete. And all you gotta do is just tap and hold here on the icon, 3D touching it, and you will get the option to quickly delete it from there. And of course, it is also easier for you to find apps from the search bar on App Library. And of course, you don't have to go through like 3 pop-ups in order to delete an app. You just go ahead, 3D touch the icon, and you will get the opportunity here to quickly delete the app you want. On the Photos app, if you go to your albums and tap the edit button right there, you will see here a minus that allows you to delete any of the albums, but did you know that you can 3D touch on any of them and actually move them around and rearrange them any way you like? So if you want to rearrange your albums, this is the way to do it. You go to all of your albums and just tap the edit button, and then of course, just like you do with icons, go ahead and move them around and place them anywhere you like. Live photos are an amazing feature of the iPhone. You shoot a live photo, it is really, really cool. So basically, it's a combination of video and photo. You have a still photo, but when you tap on it, it moves, and of course, it also has sound. But did you know that you can edit them just like you do a video? So you tap the edit button, and then when you go right here to the live section, where you can go ahead and pick the key photo, just like that, you will have these two little arrows right here at the corners. So what they allow you to do is go ahead and trim this live photo. So just move them around. You can see I can make this live photo shorter. So just like that, just cut it anywhere you want, click the done button, and now you can see this has completely changed and now is much, much shorter. So anytime you want to cut out something from a live photo, you can do that by editing it, of course, from the stock Photos app. When using the volume buttons on your device, of course, to turn up or down the volume, you can notice that once you tap here, it shows you this like volume hood right here, but you will have to tap like 10 times to bring it all the way to the top or all the way down. What you can do is just tap once, and then you can go ahead and tap with your finger, and you will have the ability here to move up and down on the slider and quickly turn up the volume all the way up or all the way down, just like that. So you just tap once just to pop this up, and then you will have the opportunity here to go ahead and move around with the slider using your finger. That way you will much quicker turn up or down the volume all the way. On the keyboard of your iPhone, you have like secret characters, and there's a degree character that you can use anywhere you want to type the degree. So you just go to the numbers here, you tap and hold the zero, and now it will show you the degree symbol right there. So this is really, really cool. You can see, just tap there, and now you will have the degree, which is really awesome. And here is another cool feature of the keyboard. Of course, we know that we can tap and hold here, it will turn into a trackpad. We can move this around and place it anywhere we want. You can do that with text here. But if you go to emoji, you can still do that. So under the emoji keyboard here, just go ahead and tap just right here. So you have no space bar here, but there is like a blank space. You tap and hold there, and it will turn the emoji keyboard into a trackpad. And now you can just move the cursor and just add an emoji anywhere you want. So that's really, really cool. And of course, much, much easier to move around on the text when you want to add emoji and you don't have the space bar there to turn the keyboard into a trackpad. And of course, very useful on the phone app when you're typing like a phone number and you maybe like forgot to enter a number here, don't want to delete it all the way. To enter that number, what you can do is just tap and hold on the number, and now it will show you like that blue cursor right there, and you can just move it around and just place it anywhere you want and go ahead and add the number just like that. Or you can just place it anywhere you want and delete a number if you have entered it by mistake. You don't have to go ahead and just delete all the numbers all the way to that one. You just tap and hold and it just pops up that blue cursor, which of course you can move anywhere you want on the number. Next up, we're talking about back tap. One of the coolest features of iOS 14. Everybody was using it, and of course it is really cool. You double tap or triple tap on the back of the phone and you can perform any action like you want, of course, which is on the list under accessibility. But now with iOS 14.3, that Apple has removed the animations, the redirection that you get when you're opening an app from a shortcut that you have added to the home screen of your device. It will be much, much better if you use double tap to open or triple tap to open apps. So any like app that you use frequently, you can go ahead and go to accessibility, go to touch, go to back tap and choose, let's say here, double tap, and of course, choose the app that you want to open. And now what you can do here is of course just double tap in order to open that app. You can see it opens now directly to the app. It won't redirect you. Before, it used to go to the shortcuts app first and then to the app that you want to open. Now, if you combine these two features, you will get instantly into an app that you want simply by double tapping or triple tapping. A really cool wallpaper trick can be found if you go to settings and go here under the wallpaper section. Now, I believe this might be available on iOS 13 as well. So you have here previews of home screen and lock screen. You have set a wallpaper. Did you know that you can readjust the lock screen wallpaper any way you like? So I can zoom in here and basically readjust it, set it another way, not just like the home screen wallpaper. And if I go here, you can see now on the lock screen, I have a readjusted wallpapers. It is different on the home screen, of course. So you can basically just tap here and just do anything you want, readjust it any way you like, and you will have a different look now on the lock screen, of course, with the same wallpaper, but is now readjusted and a different one on the home screen. On iOS 14, you can go to the edit mode, tap the dots right here, and it will take you to the pages that you have on the home screen. So if I'm here, I tap the done button, it will take me right into the page where I started. But what if I have a bunch of pages here, and when I go out of here, I want to go to that one. What I can do is just tap right there, and it will take me to that page. So from here, tap here, takes me to that one. Tap here, it will take me directly to that one. So if I want to adjust something here, I can take a look at the full page. On iOS 14, of course, you can move apps to the app library. You can also move folders. You 3D touch on a folder and you will have the opportunity here to remove the folder. Tap there, you can see you can remove from the home screen. So all the different apps that are on that folder will automatically be moved to the app library. And if you have any bookmarks, they will be placed on the home screen. On the Files app, when you want to view a file, of course, you tap on it, it opens it here. If you want to view the other files that you have on that folder, you just tap those dots right there and it will show you a list of the other files and you will see a full list. So if you have a lot of files on that folder, it will show you the complete list of files that you have there. So that is it for this video, guys. These are 17 amazing iPhone tricks that you probably didn't know existed. I hope you guys learned something new today regarding the software on your iPhone, and hopefully you will find these helpful. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys on the next one.